I'm Jeremie. I'm from Malaysia and I'm currently an artist with Singapore Dance Theatre. A quote I live by was, "We got to risk it to get the biscuit." Sometimes you have a lot of regrets, a lot of, "Oh, what if I did that? Or I should have done that," you know. And now it's just like, if you want the biscuit, you just do it. You go and do it, and then you ask questions later. This company from Germany, it was the Pina Bausch company. And then so they did the Rite of Spring, and they did Cafe Müller, I think. And the dancers had to push the chairs and the tables out of her way so she doesn't topple over, and she has no idea where she's going. It's like eyes of Malaysia. And it was just this kind of like raw intensity, how much they were actually willing to just risk everything just to show art. That kind of like resonated with me, like, okay, this is what dance is, this is what dance should be about. It should just be this raw kind of emotions of what we as humans want. You get beautiful live music on the piano every day, you get to do rehearsals, you get to work with choreographers from all around the world, you get to perform at the Esplanade. A lot of people would kill to be in your place. If you don't want to do it, someone else is more than happy to do it for you, so you just do it, because this is what you want. Like, what I would like to know more about ballet is the fact that ballet is for everybody. It's not just for females. Ballet is ultimately just dance. It's dance, and dance was what people used last time to convey before language, to convey an emotion. So it should technically be a universal thing that everybody should be about. So a lot of people, when they highlight ballet, they usually show the female side. So that's how the stereotype of ballet being female came about. So when I was a baby, probably, and when I was a kid, you know, there was no place to put me in. So they would just leave me in the corner of the studio and be like, "Here's some toys, here's some food, just keep yourself entertained." Subconsciously, you would start to pick up, you know, that music would start to sound more familiar. You start to see, oh, that's what ballet is. And also, I grew up with ballet. And then when I was about maybe 4 or 5, that's when my mom was like, "Okay, I'll just, since you're old enough to learn how to respond to instructions and follow them, let's just put you in a class." And then from about 11, 12, that's when I told my mom, "Actually, I would like to make this as a career." She was like, "Are you sure?" I was like, "Yeah." And then that's how I became a dancer.